الرحيم. السلام عليكم، ویلکم ٹو آر چینل فرینڈز ریئیکشن. ایک بار پھر خوش آمدید کہتے ہیں آپ کو اپنے چینل میں. دوستو امید رکھتے ہیں آپ سب لوگ ٹھیک ٹھاک ہوں گے اور ایک نئی ویڈیو کے ساتھ آج آپ لوگوں کے سامنے میں موجود ہوں. تو آج ایک ایسی ویڈیو ہونے جا رہی ہے جس میں آپ لوگوں کو بتانا چاہتے ہیں جو 10 ملک ہیں ایسے جس پہ امپوسیبل ٹو انویڈ، مطلب اس پہ کوئی وہ حملہ نہیں کر سکتا، کوئی قبضہ نہیں کر سکتا. 10 ایسے ممالک ہیں، اس کے بارے میں آپ لوگوں کے ساتھ شیئر کرتے ہیں. تو دوستو تمام نئے دوستوں سے گزارش ہے ہمارے چینل کو ضرور سبسکرائب کریں، ویڈیوز کو لائک کریں. تو چلیے پہلے ویڈیو دیکھتے ہیں، اس کے بعد بات کرتے ہیں.
10 کنٹریز دیٹ آر امپاسبل ٹو انویڈ. نمبر 10، ایران. یو نو یور ٹف کنٹری وین یور نک نیم از فورٹریس ایران. Despite amassing powerful enemies like the US, Turkey and Saudi Arabia, Iran hasn't been invaded since World War II. A manpower of over 500,000 soldiers, as well as 1,658 tanks and 137 aircraft, make Iran hard enough to beat in a pitched battle. But what makes a potential conquest even more difficult is the nation's mountainous terrain. The topography of Iran is similar to that of Afghanistan, and that country is still full of small pockets of terrorist fighters years after the NATO invasion. Iran's government already has a network of underground missile bases and claims that they exist 500 meters under every city and province in the country. An invading force would have to take out each secluded base one by one, a bloody and endless process. Many also suspect that the Iranian nuclear program is being used to create nuclear weapons. Although the Iran nuclear deal may make some progress in limiting the country's nuclear ambitions, Iran has recently started testing missiles capable of carrying a nuclear warhead. A nuclear defense would make an invasion even less fun for anyone who doesn't like giant doses of radiation poisoning. Number 9. Australia. Fun fact, Australia's army once lost a war against emus. So invading them ought to be as simple as marching in, putting your feet up and ordering a Foster's, right? Well, there's two things you're forgetting. One, Foster's is terrible, don't order it. And two, Australia is a floating desert in the middle of nowhere. The country is nearly 11,000 kilometers from the nearest military that could take them on. And no, it's not that military powerhouse Vanuatu. Japan is the only country near enough and powerful enough to consider an invasion, and they've been an ally of the land down under for decades. Even if you reach Australia, your problems are only just beginning. 98% of the Aussie population may live around the coasts, but you'd still have to conquer the outback, which makes up 70% of the nation's landmass. That leaves a desert thousands of kilometers wide for the Australian army to hide in and conduct guerrilla raids from. During World War II, Japan did actually plan an invasion of Australia, but they abandoned it for pretty much all the above reasons. Number 8. Russia. If you want to know how an invasion of Russia typically works out, just ask Napoleon or Hitler. Two of history's most powerful armies rolled into Russia and, within a few years, they were rolled right back out again. The key to Russia's safety is its geography. It's the largest country in the world, and much of that land is either surrounded by mountains or covered in more snow than a polar bear's wet dream. During World War II, the Russian army spent months retreating, willingly giving up land because they knew it would leave the Nazis stranded and freezing to death. It worked, and the botched invasion became a key factor in Hitler's downfall. Modern-day Russia also has a formidable army at its disposal, with 845,000 active military personnel, the fifth largest in the world. On top of this, Russia could call upon its 3,500 military aircraft and its fleet of 350 warships. Oh, and they have over 7,000 nuclear missiles, second only to the US. So even if you survive a regular winter, you'll still have their nuclear winter to deal with. Number 7. North Korea. There aren't many things that Kim Jong-un has that would be considered one of the best in the world. But one thing he can boast about is his substantial army. North Korea has over 1 million active soldiers, 4,200 tanks and 222 attack helicopters. That gives them a larger military than every NATO member except Uncle Sam. More importantly, they're also believed to have nuclear weapons capable of reaching South Korea, Japan and possibly the west coast of the US. Recently, tensions have been high in the region as North Korea pushes ahead with nuclear tests. Troop movements by America, China and Russia indicate that an invasion could occur in the near future. If a war does happen, it would take the combined forces of America, South Korea and Japan to make an effective invasion remotely feasible. Even then, a minimum of hundreds of thousands of people would die, a toll too high for most countries to stomach. So Kim Jong-un can kick back with a few bottles of wine. In the short term at least, he's probably safe from invasion. Number 6. Bhutan. If you've never heard of this country, we don't blame you. Bhutan is one of the most secluded nations on Earth. Tucked away in the Himalayas, it has an army of only 6,000 men with no artillery and no air force. Yet Bhutan belongs to a very short list of nations that have never been invaded. In the 1700s, they were attacked by the British Empire, because honestly, who hasn't been attacked by the British Empire? And they lost. But this defeat merely forced an allegiance with Britain, not a full annexation. Nowadays, an invasion would be impossible for two main reasons. The first is the terrain. Hiking your way 3,000 meters above sea level to Bhutan can cause altitude sickness, and tanks would have no chance of making the trip. And the second is that India has decided to take the small state under its protection. India supplies weapons, money and training to Bhutan's minor army. It has also promised to use its slightly larger army of 1,200,000 soldiers to protect the nation. These factors, along with a complete lack of incentive for anyone to invade, give Bhutan pretty substantial protection. Number 5. Israel. When you're a small country surrounded by people who don't want you to exist, you don't really have any choice but to become tough as shit. Israel has been in 8 wars in its short 69-year history, and it has never lost one. Though it only has an army of 176,000 troops, the country introduced mandatory military service in 1949. Women have to serve in the military for a minimum of 24 months, and men have to spend 36 months there. This means that a significant proportion of Israel's population is trained for warfare, and the state could call on another 1.5 million soldiers if it needed to. Israel has also developed the best missile defense system in the world, the Iron Dome. And no, there's not an actual giant dome covering Israel like in the Simpsons movie. The Israeli Defense Force uses the craziest means of defense possible, shooting enemy missiles out of the sky with their own missiles. This insanely badass defense has successfully shot down 90% of enemy missiles before they reach their target. Number 4. Canada. The Canadians may act all nice and polite, but anyone who's seen an ice hockey match knows that they can play rough when they want to. And with a highly trained and professional army of 95,000 soldiers, taking on Canada's army would be a substantial feat in its own right. But Canada doesn't even need to fall back on its own military. Like Russia, its size and icy climate make launching a sizable force against the nation extremely difficult. On top of this, most of the population of Canada lives near its only land border, which happens to be shared with the world's most powerful military and Canada's ally. So unless you want to fight your way through America to get there, the only way into Canada is by sailing through half-frozen waters, landing in the most remote parts of the country. Then you have to trudge south through 6 meters of snow and minus 50 degrees Celsius temperatures to get to the cities. And then, after all that, America will probably just attack you anyway. Number 3. Switzerland. It's easy to forget that Switzerland even has an army. After all, it doesn't get a lot of action. The country has been reliably neutral since 1815, and if you can turn a blind eye to the whole World War II thing, it's unlikely you're going to be dragged into any war soon. Still, if an invasion ever does rudely disturb them from their busy lives of clockmaking, the Swiss army could put up a pretty good fight. The Swiss Armed Forces has 150,000 personnel and 156 aircraft. That army may be relatively small, but it's also used to fighting in the Alps. Unless you happen to have a biathlon champion in your army, the Swiss are going to be able to outmaneuver you up the mountains and down the slopes. You won't be able to catch them off guard either. Swiss soldiers are legally required to keep their weapons with them at home. More important than their army is the fact that they never use it. Switzerland's famous neutrality means that all the powerful nations surrounding it are allies. An invading force would have to contend with France, Germany, and scariest of all, Liechtenstein. Number 2. Japan. A country has to be pretty hardcore to be one of the oldest civilizations on Earth, and one that still has never been invaded. Despite a long history of people trying, Japan has never been overrun. Even the Mongols couldn't conquer the Japanese, and the Mongols basically did nothing but conquer people. Of course, Japan has been defeated, but it took America dropping a couple of nukes on them to do it, and even then, Japan was never fully invaded. Nowadays, an invasion would be even harder. Since 2016, Japan has ramped up its military spending to $40 billion. They have 250,000 soldiers at their disposal and over 600 tanks. Japan's air force of 1,590 aircraft is the fifth largest and the most technologically advanced in the world. Plus, Godzilla would probably help out. The only weak links in Japan's defense are its aging population and surprisingly weak cyber defense, which, according to experts, is 9 times more vulnerable than other countries in Asia. Still, an invasion of Japan would require a military beyond the limits of anyone except America. Speaking of whom? Number 1. The USA. We all knew America had to be on this list somewhere. The US pumps $596 billion into its military every year, more than the next 7 highest spending nations combined. On its own, the $54 billion increase in defense expenditure proposed by President Trump is equivalent to 80% of Russia's entire military budget, on top of which the US has enough nukes to kill everyone on Earth several times over. So yeah, they're pretty safe. Even without this ridiculous military dominance, the US would be basically impossible to invade. The mere scale of the US, nearly 10 million square kilometers, would make a complete conquest a multi-year endurance test, especially when you'd need a military capable of fighting effectively in the deserts of Utah, the beaches of Hawaii, and the icy hellscape of Alaska. Actually, on second thoughts, they could have Alaska. Add that to a highly armed population that's been dreaming of this exact scenario since Red Dawn, and an invasion looks more and more far-fetched by the second. Sorry, Vlad, but it just isn't happening. So that was 10 countries that are impossible to invade. Which country do you think would be the toughest to take over? Did we leave any nations off the list? Let us know in the comments below. And if you want more creative country content, be sure to check out 10 new countries that could exist in 10 years. Playing now.
जी तो दोस्तों कैसी लगी आपको ये वीडियो जो 10 ممالک के बारे में था तो यकीनन आप लोगों को वीडियो पसंद आई होगी तो ऐसी और वीडियोस देखने के लिए हमारे चैनल को जरूर सब्सक्राइब करें और इंशाल्लाह हम लाएंगे और भी ऐसी वीडियोस आप लोगों के लिए तो इंशाल्लाह मिलेंगे अगली वीडियो में तब तक के लिए इजाजत दीजिएगा अल्लाह हाफिज़